Well, we do an agenda consultation every 5 years, basically to ask our constituents which topics do they think the board should focus on in the next couple of years, and also to make sure that we are not focusing on issues that our constituents do not find particularly important. So it's basically ensuring that the board focuses on the right issues that really concern our constituents. The main priorities of the next 5 years are, first of all, to finish the two big projects that we still have ongoing, which is insurance, which will be finished in the next couple of months. We hope to publish it in the spring of 2017. And finalizing the conceptual framework, which we also hope to publish the final version of in the spring of 2017. As the truly new theme for the next couple of years, we have chosen the theme of better communication. Preparers often see the financial statements as too much of a compliance exercise. And investors have told us that the financial statements as they are now insufficiently depict the performance of a company. One of the issues is that if you really look at it, we do not define all that much in the income statement. We define revenue, we define profit or loss, but in between we do not define all that much. And usually both preparers and investors, when they want to either depict their performance or they want to analyze the performance of a company, then they need to look at subtotals. Subtotals like EBIT, subtotals like operating income. They often want to make adjustments for exceptional items, non-recurring items, to see how persistent income is. And in that respect, IFRS helps too little. We format very little, and I think there is a need for more formatting within the income statement so that we create a little bit more comparability below the top line, below revenue. That's what people need. Well, the biggest challenge of improving performance reporting is to find those subtotals and to define them. Defining, for example, operating income is very difficult because different sectors of the economy have different concepts of what operating income is. While investors often want more comparability, preparers like to have more flexibility in the way that they present their financial statements. So to find a happy medium between those two is going to be very difficult. So I think it's going to be a very worthwhile effort, but it's going to be quite challenging. We have a rigorous research program. All new standards, before we actually start with a standard setting, we want to make absolutely sure that, first of all, there is a problem. There is an accounting problem, and if there is an accounting problem, that we can fix it. In the past, we delved into the standard setting often a little bit too early, only to find out later that we were heading in the wrong direction or that there was no solution to be found. We want to make the standard setting process more efficient, take less time, and that means we are going to invest more in the research program. Every issue is going to go into research before the board actually starts discussing it. So the research program is not a parking place for difficult issues. No, it is a regular part of our whole standard setting process. Well, in the past, we quite frankly did not do all that much in terms of helping our constituents implement a new standard. We wrote our standards and then we thought our job was done. We disbanded, we would disband our project team, and our constituents would have to figure out how to go about it. These days we already do a lot more. We do not no longer disband the project team once the standard has been written. They stay around for a while, they can answer questions in an informal setting. We have, for a couple of difficult standards, we have created transition resource groups where preparers and auditors would come around the table and discuss difficult issues of implementation. So we do a lot more. We will go on doing that, and we will also invest more in our educational efforts, which are also very helpful in helping our constituents dealing with our standards.